Since its independence in November 1948, Lebanon, the small Arab country, has been the scene of a myriad of conflicts, challenges, and political bickering. The year 2020 was not unlike any other year, but even more challenging. As the country was engulfed in the economic, financial, and monetary crisis, another challenge hit the global scene in the form of a novel coronavirus. The first few positive cases of COVID-19 in Lebanon forced the country, like the rest of the world, into a lockdown. This lockdown was preceded by an unseen monetary crisis where the Lebanese lira plummeted against the U.S. dollar. U.S. sanctions on Lebanon led banks to limit cash withdrawals, and queues were seen daily facing banks. Observers look at the year 2020 as being one of the darkest periods in Lebanon's history.
We've lost everything, literally. You know, we've lost the companies, we've lost the banks, we've lost the economical system, we've lost the political system. There's nothing left. And you know, when you have nothing left, the only thing left is humans and their potentials.
The overall system of governance in Lebanon is seen as something that needs to end. Waking up to a new crisis had become a norm until the Beirut port blast. A large amount of ammonium nitrate exploded. The explosion ripped through the port of Beirut, killing over 200 people and wounding over 6,500, destroying large parts of the city. With a multifaceted crisis in the Mediterranean country, the explosion in the Beirut port in August of 2020 only served as an additional, unprecedented blow and a national tragedy for all Lebanese. However, politicians and the media remained intensely at odds.
We're used to, you know, Israeli attacks. We're used to having a little bit of, you know, security incidents on the ground. But we have never been used to something so huge. As huge as it is, I guess it was great for uniting the Lebanese over, you know, a cause. This time and during the blast, we didn't find part of the Lebanese being happy for, you know, blasting another part of Lebanon. It was like, you know, general for all sects, for all people. And I guess it was a turning point because Sayyid Hassan Nasrallah said that at this point we really need to rethink the political system in Lebanon. It was the first time he ever said that publicly on air.
Following the blast, Prime Minister Hassan Diab was forced to step down in respect for the victims. Investigations into the blast are still pending. Same goes for talks on forming a new government. Although the majority of Lebanese factions agreed to name Saad Hariri as prime minister, it seems the year 2020 will end and the formation of a new government remains in limbo. Maryam Saleh, Press TV, Beirut.